Hi, I just want to welcome you to my Facebook Live, and so I'm going to give you a few minutes to hop on and join us as I answer a common question about seers and prophets. I get this question all the time, so I thought I'd hop on tonight and just go ahead and answer that for you and share a few things in addition. So I'm going to actually put this on my main page while you guys are coming on. Let me know your name, let me know where you're from, and we'll get to know each other a little bit more as we're just waiting a bit here. Okay, let's see. I have, let's say, more options. What does that mean? I don't know. Here we go. No, there we go. Got it. Okay, I've shared it to my main page. Hello, Alessandra. It's good to see you. Hello, Richard. How are you? And can't quite pronounce your name. Clavani. I hope I said that right. Danette, hello. How are you? By the way, I just got back from my family vacation. My husband and I, our kids, we went to our annual beach vacation, and so I got my surfing fix in for the week. I don't know if any of you surf, but it's one of the things that I like to do. And so, hello, Andre and Gloria, hello. Good to have you on. Cynthia, great to have you. Just want to let you know, by the way, this book is in. We're going to begin shipping Monday. I hope you can see it with the glare. But Prophetic Secrets, it's really, I was looking at the table of contents, and it has one word specifically all over it. Is the word wisdom. You know, it talks about chapter 1, discovering the gift of prophecy. Chapter 2, prophetic words need prophetic wisdom. Number 3, perceiving the prophetic word. Number 4, the spirit of wisdom. Number 5, anointed to see. Number 6, wisdom and secrets for prophets. Number 7, stay with ancient paths. 8, wisdom for vision, dreams, and signs. So really, it's packaged with wisdom. It's funny, you write a book and you forget what you write sometimes, you know, or how you wrote it. And I was like, wow, this has got wisdom all over it. So we're shipping out on Monday. I left a link for you in the title line. You can order directly from me, or you can go to like Amazon, Barnes & Noble, any of those online retailers. Book distributors, you can get it from them as well. Also want to point you to the Seers and Prophets Online University. We were planning on having it like we normally do at Harvest Church in Turlock, California, but because of Governor Newsom's changes, it's made it impossible for us to plan anything with excellence at this time. So we've converted it to a 5-month university. Added in a few speakers. As you notice, Apostle Eckhart's going to join us, Jamie Galloway's going to join us, in addition to Patricia King and Sean Smith. And then Michelle Passy's going to come in and help with prophetic activations. Perhaps you've experienced that with us together before. So we're going to kick that off in October. There is an early bird pricing going on right now. Check it out. Love to have you be a part. There'll be sessions every week. It's going to be really intense. One of the things I've been wanting to drill into is accuracy in the prophetic, which means you have to have a good foundation, good learning, good community. But what's next on God's timetable is he's releasing the word of knowledge, like the facts and figures, you know, those kind of people that used to freak us all out. Well, that's going to be more normal. And so I want to capture this within this 5-month time frame and get you going get you going with it, because Michelle and I, we have done this before. We've activated people in the word of knowledge. It's pretty shocking once you cross in and cross over that, and like that starts flowing through you. What happens is when you prophesy to somebody, a lot of times, you know, for whatever reason, they don't believe your prophetic word. They don't latch onto it, but you throw in a word of knowledge, they're going to believe you. So that's why we activate and we equip and we show it to you in the word. You know, we'll get you started in the word. I promise you, it'll be right in the word, and we'll kick you off in the word of knowledge, right straight from the word of God. And you're going to find out that God speaks to you a lot more accurately than you thought. So anyway, that's one of my targets. I have a lot of targets, but we also appeal to the seers and the more mystically inclined people, especially those of you who have not found a place in the church yet, because nobody understands you, or you're just, you know, still maybe feeling like a, a square peg in a round hole is because you're not, you don't really have the right community around you yet. And so we've been able to bridge that a lot and help normalize you because you're very, very valid in the body of Christ, and there is a place for you. Some of it is just learning how to communicate to more linear thinkers. And so, you know, we really work on bridging that. But first of all, I want to let you know that is totally our language. I know how to speak that language. And so look forward to having that kind of expression come in, which leads me to the question that I wanted to answer tonight is, what's the difference between a prophet and a seer? Because I hear that all the time, especially since we're calling this the Seers and Prophets Online University. And I just talk about that in general, and then of course it always raises the questions, well, how do I know if I'm a prophet? You know, and so we'll hit a couple of those questions tonight because I just get them all the time. Might as well answer them up front. And so, so first of all, let's go back. Let's say, how do I know if I'm a prophet or not? Okay, so there's the gift of prophecy, 1 Corinthians chapter 12. A lot of gifts of the Spirit that are listed in that passage alone. It's not all the gifts of the Spirit in the New Testament, but it is, you know, there's 9 there. One of them is, you know, the gift of prophecy. And so, you know, it's really a gift from the Holy Spirit. We actually see it emerge in mass in Acts chapter 2 is part of the benefit of actually receiving the baptism, the immersion of the Holy Spirit in power. You know, this has been prophesied for centuries, and then in Acts chapter 2 that actually happened. The Holy Spirit fell upon the church in, you know, while they were praying, and the church was birthed. And so what is the outflow? And you see this pattern all the time throughout Old Testament and New Testament. When the Holy Spirit comes upon people, they begin to prophesy. Well, now the Holy Spirit has come upon, you know, the body of Christ, like in mass. And so the outflow is the prophetic word. And so, you know, when it talks about the gift of prophecy, I believe it's one of the easiest gifts to step into. It has the most permission on it. And the downside of it is, it seems like the Holy Spirit doesn't wait for you to have maturity or character to actually anoint you with this. I don't know why, but that's just how he does it. But you know, if you want to have any validity, if you want people to actually listen to you, you need to have some character, because they'll toss you out at some point if that's not developed. But you know, in the onset, it's pretty cool when you see new Christians get baptized in the Holy Spirit and they start prophesying, you know, just like really, really amazing stuff, you know, because, you know, they don't know not to, okay? And so so that's the gift of prophecy, but it's amazing how accurate and how wonderful that can be in just the ordinary believer, you know? And that's not even a prophet. A prophet's different. A prophet carries government. A prophet carries an anointing to lead. It's completely different. This is when we jump over to Ephesians chapter 4, and it talks about the gifts of Christ. So what I just mentioned before was the gifts of the Holy Spirit, 1 Corinthians chapter 12. And then in Ephesians 4, we're talking about the gifts of Christ. That's when we talk about the apostle, the prophet, the pastor, the teacher, and the evangelist. And these are men and women of God who are anointed to lead out from that kind of anointing. You know, and so apostles will apostle, and prophets will prophet, and you know, and evangelists will do what they do, but there's an anointing on them. And one of the responsibilities they have is to mature and equip the saints to do the work of ministry. So prophets typically will equip and train. That's what I do. I equip and train, equip and train. And so you might say to yourself, well, I have a track record, some really, like, you know, the Lord has spoken to me, I've had dreams, I have this and that, I have a real track record, but I don't know if I'm a prophet or not. Well, if you don't know, then you're probably not. It's possible that Jesus might appear to you at some point and anoint you as a prophet. That's possible. You know, but it's not something we really, you know, we're not looking to get promoted or progress to a prophet. Like either you're going to be one or you're not, or either you are one or you're not. Because of the weighty nature of it, and because of the warfare attached to it, it's not something you want to title yourself just because you think it's cool. You know, it really, really is weighty. And then once you know, if you ever, you know, have an encounter with Jesus and he calls you as a prophet, He makes it abundantly clear to you, number one. And number two, you pretty much go to the backside of the desert to get equipped and trained. You go into the Holy Spirit school, boot camp school of training, prophet training. And it, it's basically to equip you to deliver nations. So that's when you're going to get your muscles. And we don't get our muscles because it's easy. We get our muscles because life gets really interesting and really hard. So anyway, my point is this, if God is called you to be one, it's okay. If he has, grace to you. It's amazing. Once you get into like these good spaces, these good places, and you've gone into some more maturity, then we start seeing the fruit of the ministry of it. But there's a hard space with it, okay? But if Jesus has called you as a prophet, there's going to be some kind of encounter, because he's calling you. It's not like a mystery. He's going to call you. He's going to have some kind of encounter with you. And then there's the whole thing about the church receiving you as a prophet. You don't have to announce it. They'll know, and they'll actually confirm it at some point. So and then you'll actually be a prophet to the church. And so it's very interesting how this all works. So that leaves us to say this. Okay, so what's the difference then between a prophet and a seer? That's really where we want to land. And so a prophet, Old Testament, we'll go back into the Old Testament roots here. A prophet, the seer, let's go back to the seer prophets. Seers were the original prophets in the Old Testament for whatever reason. And we see that in the book of Samuel, and it says that they would go to the seer, and that was the original word for a prophet. And that's because they would have visions and dreams. That's where they got their words, their prophetic words. They would get it out of visions and dreams for the most part. And so they would see the word of the Lord versus hearing the word of the Lord, which is what came later, is the Nabi prophet. That's a Hebrew word. The seer Hebrew word was rohi, chose. There's a couple Hebrew words for that functionality. Then it was the word Nabi, and that was, the bubbling up of the prophetic word. And so that's how that prophetic word would come. It would just bubble up. And so that's the difference between the seer prophet and the seer and the prophet. They're both prophets, but one sees and one the word would bubble up, or they just know that they know the word of the Lord, and they've had that encounter, and they've been called as prophets and everything. So that doesn't mean that people don't see in the spiritual realm. However, you don't have to be a prophet to see in the spiritual realm. You can hear the word of the Lord, you can see the word of the Lord. It's just the gift of prophecy functioning through you, because you've given your life to Jesus and you've been anointed by the Holy Spirit, you've been baptized by the Holy Spirit. And so that's kind of like, just a boilerplate, real simplistic understanding of the difference between a seer, and I'm talking about the seer prophet, and a prophet, the rohe, chose, and the nabi prophet. And it's really functionality. And just simply how they hear the word of God. Not one's better than the other. They both have the pros and their cons. The seers are constantly trying to figure out, how do I say what I just said? Or how do I say what I just saw? Because it's very intangible. The nabi prophets, it's like this bubbling up. And it's just, it's almost like word for word, paragraph for paragraph, that kind of thing. And so that's how they flow. That's how they function. And sometimes they cross over a little bit, but not always. I'm more of a seer prophet, visions and dreams, especially dreams. I used to be more visions. It seems my lately last, 5 or 6 years, just been dreams. But other stuff happens as well. But again, it's not a competition. We're not competing for the latest, greatest dream, or the latest functionality. It's just how we flow. And we just thank the Lord for that, okay? And so I just wanted to give you a heads up on that, and also invite you to get the book, Prophetic Secrets, and join the online university that starts in October. I look forward to seeing you there. Thank you so much. God bless. Take care.